Hello, everybody. My name is Erin Jakubowski. I am a virtual health and wellness coach with our community called The Sisterhood. I was asked to come speak with you guys today about health and wellness and caring for yourself during this amazing nursing week. First and foremost, I have to say thank you for having me. It's an absolute honor to speak with you today with, especially during this time where you nurses are giving, giving, and giving more than you ever likely have before. You are a group of what I would coin superhumans, completely giving more to everybody else than yourselves on a regular basis. You are absolutely servant leaders, and it's my honor to speak with you today about health and wellness and you taking care of you. As natural caregivers, I would beg to say that you spend the majority of your time giving to other people more than you give back to yourself. And I would beg to say that that sometimes, especially now in this stature state of the world that we're in, I would beg to say that that continuous of giving and giving and giving and caring for other people can leave you feeling sometimes drained, exhausted, running on empty, like emotionally empty. Maybe you have less to give to your own family, less to give to yourself. Like maybe you're a little bit disconnected or resentful because at this point you're giving, giving, giving without anything left to give to yourself. And I know, like as a parent, as a mother, as somebody who cares and gives to other people, that is our joy. It's our passion. It's our excitement. It's what brings us happiness. But in the same breath, it can also take so much from you. And unless you're taking care of yourself, you will not have more to continuously give and give and give. So it's my honor to speak with you today about you taking time for you to fill your own cup. And I will say first and foremost, the only way you're going to fill your own cup is if you decide that you deserve it. You decide to give yourself time. You decide to prioritize yourself. And you decide to do it because nobody is going to come in your house and tell you it's time to take care of you. Nobody is going to say, hey, knock, knock, Karen, it's time to take care of you today. It's on you. It's on you to prioritize yourself, to commit to taking time for yourself and commit to filling your cup first. I know often at the end of a week or maybe at the end of a long shift or at the end of you giving and giving and giving, sometimes it feels like we can give back to ourselves by having like a big glass of wine, some popcorn, maybe treating on some takeout or having like some extra dessert or whatever. It feels like we're like treating ourselves, right? Like that feels in the moment like, oh, I deserve this. I've been giving so much. I deserve this. I'm treating myself. But there is a huge difference between treating yourself and treating yourself well. And I am here to help you to differentiate between I'm going to treat myself today to I'm going to treat myself well today. And choosing those like positive coping mechanisms, those things in our life that can truly treat ourselves well to help us be our best us, to help us like replenish and refill our cup and reignite who we are. It's not the wine and the treats and the popcorns and the takeout and the like Netflix. It's finding good things that will actually fill our cup and like rejuvenate us. So I wanted to come on here today and give you some like tangible tips on things that you can do that are easy at home to like genuinely give back. My first tip, I have five. My first tip for you is to start with a gratitude practice. And maybe this feels like a little, here we go, mumbo jumbo. She's into like that woohoo stuff. But truly, the moment you are grateful for who you are, what you have, everything in your current life, the less anxious you are, the less focused you are on the negativity and the more focused you are on the good. And the more you focus on the good, the better it gets. This is my first recommendation. It's called The Magic. If you're familiar with the book, The Secret, it's the same author, but it's totally different. This book is entirely focused on gratitude. And it actually has, I think it's 30-day exercise. Every single day you read a small chapter of like 3 to 5 pages, and it gives you an activity to do every single day to help you be more grateful and have more of a like relationship with gratitude. It changed my life in terms of focusing on gratitude. I highly recommend it. Otherwise, if you're not into books, truly just taking a pen and paper and putting word to what you're grateful for every single day, 3 to 5 things, writing them down. Maybe it is somebody in your life. Maybe it is the roof over your head. Maybe it's the sun shining that day, but just taking time to focus on the good will help it get better. This other journal I've used for a long time, it's the Start Today Journal by Rachel Hollis. In it, you write every single day things you're grateful for, and then every single day things you're working towards. It really helps you focus on positivity, gratitude, and like the direction you're taking your life. Love it. So number one is a gratitude. Number two is genuinely moving your body. And I know that you guys are like busy bees, you're moving all the time, but there's a difference between working and moving your body and moving your body for you and like being in tune with your body and its mechanics and how it works and moving it for you, for joy, for like a release. In our community, the sisterhood, we try to get a 30-minute workout in every day. Sometimes that's yoga, sometimes that's lifting weights, sometimes that's dancing, whatever that is that makes you happy, that fuels you, that like gives you those positive endorphins and gives you that high, try and do that. Like my favorite line is move your body, change your mind. If you are feeling exhausted, down in the dumps, like truly just putting your running shoes on, going out for a 30-minute walk, speed run, whatever, change your mind, move your body, change your mind. Try and move your body as much as you can every week, not just at work, but like for you. My number three tip is drinking more water. It seems super simple. I've really started to try and drink a gallon of water every single day. Yes, I'm going to the bathroom more often, but it replenishes me. It fills me with good things. It gives me life. It makes me have more energy. So instead of reaching for extra coffee every day, try and get a big jug of water and pour from it every day. So you see actually how much water you're drinking every day. And you can be like, oh man, I'm not drinking enough. Or yeah, I feel great today. And this is why, right? Gratitude journal, move your body, drink more water. Number four is find a podcast or book that really like fills your soul, fills your cup, helps you feel good. I have some great recommendations here for you. One of my favorites, it's recent, is by Jay Shetty, Think Like a Monk. It is an incredibly mind-blowing, eye-opening book that talks about like your mindset, how you think about things, how you live your life, the values in your life. Like he's incredible. I'm sure you can get this on audio and he has like that gorgeous British accent. So if you want to listen to that, but he's incredible. It's a book that really changed my perspective. If you are a woman and you haven't heard or haven't read this book yet, it's time, especially if you are a woman who is a mom. This is freeing and incredible. Love this book. You Are a Badass absolutely changed my life and gave me permission to start taking time for me, gave me permission to start like truly investing in who I was instead of giving and giving, giving to everybody else. Highly recommend it. If you are at a place where you like want massive change in your life, you want to have like changeover, you want to change things in your life, you want to change habits, you want to change careers, you want to change anything, these two books will help you. Super Attractor. Oh, and Manifesting Change. This one more than anything was incredible. But both of these are talking about like attracting positive energies to you, manifesting change, living the life you want, like dreaming for the life you want and going after the life you want. Incredible. If you don't have time for books, because I really felt like I didn't have time for books between work and kids and all of the things, I just committed to reading for 10 minutes a day. 10 minutes. So maybe that means you waking up literally 15 minutes earlier and sitting and reading for 10 minutes. Or maybe that means you like carving out time throughout like your time. I'm not sure what your schedules are so crazy. Maybe that means listening to a podcast while you drive to work. Whatever it is, find time to like fill your mind with positivity. I think so often we're over consuming the media and the news and social media and all those things, and all that stuff is going in there. If you aren't filling your mind with positivity and goodness and good thoughts, then they're not going to be in there. It's not like magically you're going to start taking care of yourself and magically you're going to start being more positive, right? You have to consciously be filling your mind with positivity. So recap, gratitude journal, moving your body, drinking some more water, reading a positive book or a podcast every day, like 10 minutes every day of just consciously filling your mind with positivity. And number five, guys, is start to eat real food. Good food. I know it's so hard, especially if you're on shift work, especially if you're like, go, 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 go. But truly, eating more vegetables every single day will change your life. Consciously choosing better choices every single day, knowing like, okay, I wanna treat my body well instead of I wanna treat my body, it will change your life. And the more you fuel your body with good food, the more you fuel your body with goodness, the better you feel. But at the end of the day, I can preach all these great things that you can do for yourself. You need to decide that you want to make yourself a priority. You need to decide that you deserve to be a priority in your own life. You need to decide that you're worth it and that you want to take time for yourself. So maybe that starts off at 10 minutes, like I say, maybe that's 30 minutes. Maybe you're gonna try and carve out that time specifically for you to just go for a walk every day. Whatever it is, guys, you need to start making you your number one priority. If I were to ask you truly all the priorities in your life, how long would it take for you to say yourself? How long would it take for yourself to be on that list? Because you should be your number one priority for you. The more you take care of you, the more you can give back to other people. But if you don't take care of you, you're not gonna be very good for anybody else. You're not gonna be that servant leader at work. You're not going to be that most amazing nurse that you can be. It's time for you to take a step back and take time for you. I can hardly wait to hear the changes that you're gonna make and how you're going to prioritize yourself. I would love to hear how this video helped you implement anything. You can find me at Erin Jakubowski on Instagram or on Facebook. My email is erinjakubowski@gmail.com. So thank you so much for having me. It was an absolute pleasure. I can't wait to hear how you start taking care of you too. Bye guys.